name's James Fugate. I'm from Ohio. I grew up in a little small town. Had a pretty normal childhood, just a middle-class income family. I was around 13, 14 years old. My sister and her older friends, they were already into the, you know, the smoking of the marijuana and stuff of that age. So I just fell into that trap as well. That was pretty much a beginning of my career as a addict. Graduated high school, started working on cars, and my addiction was getting worse. It was spiraling more and more out of control. I finally met my wife in 1990, and we had our first kid, and he's 21 years old now today. And my second son was born in 2006, AJ, Ashton James. I never did get out of my addiction. I was always, you know, trying to just living in darkness. And at this time, I did not know Jesus at this time at all. My wife got diagnosed with cancer. She fought it for 18 months, and we lost her in 2014. She left me two kids, and she was young. She was only 40 years old. After she passed, I just didn't know how to react to that, and you know, the whole life change. And the only thing I knew to do was to turn to what I knew best at that time, and that was, you know, in my addiction. It got really, really, really bad after that. I ended up ODing one night. I woke up in the hospital 3 days later, and they had a child protection service was there waiting when I woke up, and they just wanted to take my kids from me. My father, thank God for him, he stepped in and said he would take custody of them if I'd sign them over to him. That's exactly what I did. You know, this addiction, it doesn't matter where you live or where you go, it'll find you, especially if you're an addict, it'll find you. You know, I thought I had everything under control, but the addiction reared its ugly head again on me. I had nowhere to go. I ended up being homeless. I was trying to fill a void in my heart that I couldn't fill. It was dark. Everything was just so dark to me. I started crying out, you know what I mean? I knew I needed help. I knew I needed help really, really bad. In that process, when I was crying out, I finally heard God crying loudly to me to find him, to find God. And in that process, that's when my life started to change. I made a decision. I heard about Set Free Ministries. I made a decision to go to Set Free Ministries. And that was the start of my journey with Jesus. I was just trying to get through the program just to get back, you know, try to get back on my feet. The more I stayed there, the more I got into the Word, the more the Word got into me, and more Scripture got into me. And when that happened, about 3 or 4 months in, I finally surrendered and I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. My life is nowhere perfect at all, but I have focus today. I have direction. I have an ever-growing relationship with all my brothers and sisters. I've learned to live in His will and not mine. I try to take myself out of the equations on anything, and I pray. I have prayer. I have faith. I have God in my life now. I graduated to the second phase of Set Free, and at this point we're allowed to try to get a job and try to get back into society. Tommy Davis invited me in. My background was kind of terrible, but we worked through that, and my journey started with Jesus at Set Free Ministries. But when I actually got out into working at Fernandina Baptist, that's when my foundation started getting roots. They gave me direction. They guided me. We always share the Word with each other. It's just a blessing to me to have like-minded Christian people in my life. You know, as this new season in my life takes shape, I'm not afraid. I got kind of a heart for trying to lead and guide a younger generation, you know, try to lead and guide them to Jesus, and try to get their life on the right path to salvation, and that's kind of where my heart's at. Hopefully, wherever I'm going, I can make that happen, or God can make that happen for me. It's just a blessing to be able to work there. I never thought a guy like me would ever be able to work in a church or somewhere like that. God does amazing things in your life as long as you call on His name. He will lead and guide and direct you in all your ways. You know, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Love your neighbor and go to church. It is as simple as that. Go to church. That's what God calls us to do, go to church.